أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، فإنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وهزم الأحزاب وحده، وأشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله. يقول الله عز وجل: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ويقول أيضا: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله، وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وما قل وكفى خير مما زاد وألها، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. أحبتي في الله، كيف حالكم مع الله؟ كيف حال إيمانكم؟ اعلموا أحبتي في الله أن الإيمان قول وعمل واعتقاد ونية وإقرار وسنة، قول باللسان والقلب وعمل بالقلب والجوارح، يزيد وينقص، يزيد بالطاعات وينقص بالمعاصي. واعلموا أن التوحيد توحيد عملي وعلمي، علمي أن تقر لله بالربوبية وبأسمائه وبصفاته، وعملي بأن تقصد الله عز وجل وحده بالعبادة، وهذا هو توحيد الألوهية. وفقنا الله إلى التوحيد الخالص والإخلاص واليقين، ونستكمل سويا ما بدأناه من رحلتنا الإيمانية مع العلم والإيمان، أو الإيمان والعلم. وقد وقفنا عند كيفية تحقيق الإخلاص كي تعلم الله عز وجل وتعبده حق عبادته، وقد عرفنا الإخلاص وأنواعه وكيف يكون الإخلاص، وأيضا عرفنا الفرق بين العبد المخلص والمخلص، وبدأنا في فضائل الإخلاص، وعلمنا أن من فضائل الإخلاص أن بالنيات الصالحات الخالصات تكون المباحات عبادات وطاعات، وعلمنا أيضا أن من فضائل الإخلاص أنه يزيل الهم ويفرج القرب، وعلمنا أيضا أن من عوامل انتزاع الغل والحقد من القلب هو الإخلاص، وأيضا من عواملها هو الاجتماع على الجماعة والسمع والطاعة لولي الأمر في غير معصية يأمر بها. وقد وضحنا ضوابط الخروج على ولي الأمر، ووضحنا كيف يكون التصرف إذا أمر بكفر أو معصية، وأخذنا من أمثلة في من عصر التابعين والصحابة كيف كان الخروج على الحاكم سبباً في حفير الدماء، وكيف كان ذلك فتنة للمسلمين كما حدث في موقعة الحرة وغير ذلك. ونستكمل سوياً اليوم بواقي أفضال أو فضائل الإخلاص. So today, inshallah, we're continuing what we started about the sincerity, which is a part of Iman, which is a part of ilm. Because in order to have sincerity, you should have knowledge, should have ilm. And we explained the advantages of the ikhlas. And we explained last time the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that one of the reasons that stop your heart from having a hurt and having a weakness in the heart is to have sincerity. And the next advantages of the ikhlas, أن الإخلاص طريق للنصر. The إخلاص, the sincerity, is a way for victory. اعلم أخي الحبيب أن الله عز وجل قد ينصر الأمة بإخلاص عبد من هذه الأمة. Allah عز وجل will support the Ummah, will bring the victory to the Ummah because of one sincere person, because of his dua, because of his supplication, because of his prayer. وانظر إلى أو اسمع إلى هذا الحديث عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: إنما ينصر الله هذه الأمة بضعيفها بدعوتهم وصلاتهم وإخلاصهم. So Allah Azza wa Jal will support and bring the victory for the Ummah because of their supplication, because of their weakness or the weak person's supplication and their salah and their sincerity. So al-ikhlas sabab lil-nasr. Al-ikhlas is the reason for victory. وَعْلَمْ أَخِي الْحَبِيبِ أَنَّ الْإِخْلَاصَ سَبَبٌ فِي ذَوَالِ الْهُمُومِ وَالْكُرُوبِ. Sincerity is a reason will remove the worries and the remove the distress in your life. وَهَذَا because when you have sincerity, you rely only on Allah Azza wa Jal. Even you have a trial, even you have a hardship, still, since you have a sincerity and believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, this will be removed. And انظر, look to the story of the three people that mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, and all of you know this story. These three people entrapped in a cave, and a big rock blocked the door of this cave, and they realized nothing will resolve this hardship except the dua by their righteous deed, especially the sincere righteous deed. And in this story of these three people, the first one, his sincere action, he looked after for his parent. He spent all the day looking for the food for his family and his parent, and his parent used to wait for him to drink the milk before he go to sleep. And one night he was late and his parent slept, and he was very upset about that. And he returned back and he found his kids, his wife, waiting for the milk as well. But he don't look for them. He went straight away to his parents and he stand in front of their bed, waiting for them to wake up. And then when they wake up, they give them a cup of milk. This is because the birrul walidaini, the sincere looking after the parents, and then the rock partially open for the gate. The second one, which is stopping to do the ma'siyah, the major sins, because of the fear from Allah Azza wa Jal. This person, he loved his cousin, his one of his relatives, and he tried to do fahisha, zina with her, but she stopped him. And one day she was looking for money. She had a problem in her life, and she went to him to give her this money, but he told her, if you want money, we have to do the zina, the adultery with me. And then she on necessity, and she agreed. But when he is the point in the time that he will go to do, going to do the zina, she remind him about Allah Azza wa Jal, about the relation between him and her as a relative. And then he stopped. While he has the ability, have the controlling to do zina, but he returned back and he asked Allah Azza wa Jal by this action, so the rock opened. But still, there is not enough to them to exit from the cave. The last one who look after and who protect the rights of the people. He hired someone to do something in his farm, and he didn't happy with the money that he gave it to him, this person. And he left without taking his money. And he kept his money with him and invested in a cattle, in a sheep and goat and cow and so. And after a while, this person returned to him looking for his hiring money, for his salary. And then he said to him, look, all this valley, including the cattle, is for you. Look how he protect and keep the rights of the people until they return. And then he asked Allah Azza wa Jal by the sincerity of this action, then the rock is open and the exit from the cave. And you can see the ikhlas in amal will be the reason for removing of distress and the hardship. Right? This is most of the advantages of the ikhlas. Now, in order to feel the sweetness of ikhlas, you have to know about the examples from the Sahaba, from Tabi'een, from the righteous people about the ikhlas. Listen to this statement by Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah. قال ابن القيم الجوزية من شهد لإخلاصه بإخلاص فإخلاصه يحتاج إلى إخلاص. If someone testified for his sincerity or for his action, it is a sincere action, so this sincerity need actually sincerity. Because you don't endorse yourself, you cannot judge yourself, I am a sincere person. I'm doing that for the sincerity. If you think that, or you witness, to be witness like that, or testify that you are a sincere person, you need to think about your sincerity. You have to fulfill the correct sincerity. أيضا علي زين العابدين, the son of الحسين بن علي. The people, he was a rich person, and he used to hide the sadaqah, the charity. And people didn't see him give any money for the poor and the needy people, because he hid it. And they saw that he is a stingy person. He is a bakhil. And until he died. And then when he do the ghusl of the death, they saw in his back a marks showing that he used to hold something on his back. And then one of his family give them the reason that he used to wait until all the family and all the people go to sleep, and he hold the bags of flour, wheat, to give it to the needy people. So look how he tried to sincere his action in absence of the people. And wa'alam akhi al-habib, anna min al-sab'ati alladhi yadhulluhum Allahu fi dhullihi yawma la dhilla illa dhillahu rajulun tasaddaqa وأخفى صدقته حتى لا تعلم شماله ما أنفقت يمينه. So a person who hide his charity, so his left hand cannot see what his right hand gives. So how can this is a person will be under the shade of Arsh al-Rahman, under the shade of the soul of al-Rahman on the Yawm al-Qiyamah. Look how sincerity give you this advantage. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عبده المصطفى. ثم أما بعد. So this is the advantages and some examples from the tabi'in and the righteous people about how they are sincere in their action. We stop on this point. We give the way or the means that help you to be a sincere for this khutbah, because I have to talk about different topic. As you hear the news, it happened in Holland, in Netherlands, and Sweden, they burned the Quran, al-Mus'haf. And every Muslim is upset by this action. So what is our response toward this action? اعلم أخي الحبيب أن القرآن هو كلام الله. The Quran is a speech of Allah. تكلمه وحفظه في اللوح المحفوظ. He spoke the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal. He's an attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal. He spoke the Quran and stored the Quran in the preserved tablet 50,000 years before he created the heaven and earth, and وكان عشور الماء, and his throne was above the water. And then he descended the Quran to the heaven of the dunya, and in the Baytul Izza, the bright house, on the 24th of Ramadan, which is the Laylatul Qadr, is the night of destiny. Then he descended the Quran through Jibreel to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam over 23 years according to the situation and the circumstances. This is the Quran. The Quran, kalamullah. It is a speech of Allah. It is not a creation. Even the Mus'haf that has been burned, the Mus'haf itself, the paper, is creation, and the ink is creation, but the wording of this Mus'haf is not a creation, it's a word of Allah. Even when you read the Quran from this Mus'haf, your eye is a creation, but the wording that you read is not a creation. When you hear the Quran by your ear is a creation, but the wording that you listen is not a creation. When you memorize the Quran by your heart is a creation, but the wording that you memorize is not a creation. When you write by your hand a verse of the Quran, your hand is a creation, but the word that you write is a creation. It's not a creation. It is a word of Allah. It is an actual speech of Allah. It is not this expression of the word of Allah. The difference between the speech of Allah and his expression of the speech of Allah is completely different. Different between Ahl Sunnah and Ahl Bid'ah. Between the Sunnah Ahl people and the innovation people. The Quran is the actual speech of Allah, not expression. Because expression means that Jibreel expresses the meaning by his own wording, which is incorrect. So, Quran, many people can read Quran. Few people can understand the Quran. Real people can practice Quran in their life. So, of course, we're very upset about this action, and we have to seek the means to express this feeling. On the other hand, we have to return back to the Quran, not only reading, not only understanding, but practicing the Quran in your life. And understanding the Quran is very important, because the Arabic language is not easy to understand the meaning, because the same word can be understood differently depending on the wording. And in order for that, you have to learn the Arabic language before you start to understand the Quran. Because if you don't understand the Arabic language, when you read the translation sometimes mislead you to understand the Quran. And in this point, there is some calls in the community now to initiate the giving the speech in the khutab, in the Jum'ah, in everywhere by English only. without Arabic. Because currently we have some scholar in here in Adelaide delivering the khutbah in Arabic totally, and then there is translation. This is very important, by the way. You have to listen to the khutbah in Arabic. Although I'm here doing some English, but I'm trying to combine both together. But the best thing to learn Arabic, the exposing to someone who speaks Arabic. يعني من أفضل وسائل تعلم اللغة العربية التعامل مع من يتكلم العربية. And if you start saying prayer, and don't say salah, time by time the generation will not know what's the meaning of salah. If you start saying fasting, time by time the people will not meaning of sawm. If you start talking about dua, saying supplication, time by time people don't know what's dua. So you have to use the Arabic definitions and Arabic terminology in ibadah, especially in salah, in dua, in khutbah, as much as you can. You can translate to the equivalent khutbah, English, but you have to know the Arabic meaning. You have to know ikhlas, which is sincerity. You have to know ibadah, worship. You have to know salah, prayer. You have to know hajj and so on. All the Arabic names, and it's very important for the scholar to be Arabic native speaker, or to learn Arabic first before he deliver his knowledge in English. If you do the opposite by bringing someone who don't know Arabic but he's good in English and then teach him how to learn Arabic, this is not recommended because he may be misunderstood the actual meaning of the word of the Quran. And Quran is not only the Mus'haf. Quran is the word of Allah Azza wa Jal. It is our way of life. It is not only reading, it is not only understanding, but it is practicing the Quran in your life. أقول قبلي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. اللهم عليك بمن حرق المصحف، اللهم عليك بمن قطع المصحف، اللهم أحصهم عددا وأبدهم بلدا ولا تبقي منهم أحدا، اللهم عليك بمن عاونهم، اللهم عليك بمن ساعد على ذلك يا رب العالمين، اللهم جاز خيرا من وقف في وجههم وشذب فعلتهم وتكلم عن صنيعهم، اللهم سدد خطاهم يا رب العالمين، اللهم عليك بأعدائك أعداء الدين، اللهم عليك بأعدائك أعداء الدين، اللهم انصرنا على القوم الكافرين، اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء همومنا وذهاب أحزاننا، وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين، اللهم عليك بأعدائك أعداء الدين، اللهم مزقهم تمزيقا، اللهم أحرقهم تحريقا، اللهم كما مزقوا وحرقوا القرآن فمزقهم أحرقهم يا رب العالمين، انصرنا عليهم يا رب العالمين، اشف صدور قوم مؤمنين، وارحمنا يا رب العالمين، وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وقوم إلى الصلاة يرحمني ويرحمكم الله.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله. استوى اعتدلوا.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ما خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما إلا بالحق، وإن الساعة لآتية، فاصفح الصفح الجميل، إن ربك هو الخلاق العليم. ولقد آتيناك سبعا من المثاني والقرآن العظيم، لا تمدن عينيك إلى ما متعنا به أزواجا منهم، ولا تحزن عليهم واخفض جناحك للمؤمنين، وقل إني أنا النذير المبين، كما أنزلنا على المقتسمين الذين جعلوا القرآن عضين، فوربك لنسألنهم أجمعين عما كانوا يعملون، فاصدع بما تؤمر وأعرض عن الجاهلين، إنا كفيناك المستهزئين، فاصدع بما تؤمر وأعرض عن الجاهلين، إنا كفيناك المستهزئين، الذين يجعلون مع الله إلها آخر فسوف يعلمون، ولقد نعلم أنك يضيق صدرك بما يقولون، فاصفح عنهم وقل سلام فسوف يعلمون.
الله
سميع الله لمن حامده.
الله 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 الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
ولقد نعلم أنك يضيق صدرك بما يقولون، فسبح بحمد ربك وكن من الساجدين، واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين.
الله
سميع الله لمن حمده.
الله 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 أكبر. الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.